Okay, so what will happen, you'll have this link and you'll have it, this link. So you'd come over here and then you download it from here. You click on this download button. It should help you download. But now my browser part of it is in Chinese. Don't worry about that one. So I'll explain step by step. So once you download it, it would be saved somewhere. And I already downloaded it. And after downloading it, it would be a zip file, and in the zip file it will have this one and this one. Now this is our database, and this one you have to untar again, so, or unzip again. Okay, so anyway, you can save it somewhere you like. Okay, and after that, actually here I have saved it. Let me show you. So I'm sorry about the pop-up, this is Windows over here in Chinese. Now over here, my Xampp is in C folder, as you can see, and sorry about the Chinese section once again. Now here I do have, and inside the htdocs, this is your Xampp root folder, and inside this I have this new app and I have this test app. Now here actually I also have this zip file. Okay, so this is the one that I'll unzip again. Actually I did it previously once again, just for testing. So I'll remove this one now. Okay, so well, it's being removed, so we can ignore that one. Okay, now here this is the one that I've downloaded. Okay, so I'll unzip it, and this computer is a bit slow, so it may take a bit of time. Okay, so now I'll unzip it to somewhere. Well, in this folder, the same folder, I'll unzip it, and I'll give it a new name over here as I unzip it. Okay, so I'll call it shopping app. Okay, all right, so it'll go ahead and download, unzip it. Okay, because a lot of you already suggested that you guys are having problem, so I just wanted to show you that how it should work. Okay, sorry about the noise, a lot of work going on around here, and my computer is a bit slow. This is the Windows, which I don't often use, so just wait. Well, with this we are done, and it unzipped it, and it's right over here. Okay, so everything is over here, and I do see that I have this env file. Okay, and everything else is here. Okay, and after that I need to make sure the database has been downloaded, but now I don't want to download this one once again, so I already have it downloaded in my other folder. So I think it was here. So what I'll do, let's see, let me take a look. Yes, it's one over here. You can put it anywhere, it doesn't really matter. So I'll go up and put it in the same directory, because I need to load it to our MySQL folder. In our Xampp server, actually, not really a folder. So now here I have everything. Okay, so all this file. Okay, now I'll go ahead and boot up our over here we do have our Xampp server, so I'll look for it. Let's see. Or let me find it from here. I think it should be over here somewhere. Yes, this one. So this is Xampp server control panel. So it's getting started, and once again, this computer is a bit slow, so we need to wait. Yes, it started. Now I'll start Apache and MySQL over here, okay? Now, because we are on Windows, so what I need to do, well, I think I had one before, so I'll close this one. So I'll keep over here, okay? Now, they're started, and if they are started, what I'll do, I'll go ahead and access the local host for phpmyadmin. So if you installed Xampp server, it's phpmyadmin is installed as a part of it. So here I would come over here, and here I would do localhost and phpmyadmin, okay? All right, so it's booting up. Okay, over here, so I'll go ahead and create a new database over here. So I'll click new, and in your case, this should be the new icon, new button, and it's getting loaded. Okay, and I'll call it shopping app, okay? So you can name it anything you want, but you should be consistent with the name, okay? Then I'll click create. So here it'll create an empty database for me. I'll click this one, select this one, and I'll come over here, and I'll click on import. So in your case, you'll see this is import. Sorry, one second, this is in Chinese. And then I'll go ahead and click choose button over here. Now I'll come to my shopping app. Now over here, I'll go over here, my htdoc, and over here, I'll open this one. And here we just saved our database, this one. So I'll open it up and then I'll click on go over here. And it would upload and put it in this under this database table, okay? So let's see. Okay, so it looks like it's done over here. Okay, now with this, we are done uploading database, okay? Now what we'll do, we'll go ahead and search for our command line terminal. So we do cmd. So here it is, okay? Well, now here is my command line. So I'll put it in the middle so you know what's going on. Now I'll go and find my Xampp server. So I would do here cd dot dot, and in my case, I do there, and we know that my Xampp server is here. So you should go to your Xampp server. Now I would do cd dot Xampp, okay? Now it would take me there. Now I would do dir over here. So we know that we have a lot of stuff over here, including our phpmyadmin and MySQL. So everything is over here. Now we'll go ahead inside htdocs. Okay, so we do cd htdocs. Okay, now here we do dir. We can do clear. Well, it looks like it didn't understand because I don't use Windows a lot. Anyway, so here we do see our shopping app. So we do cd shopping app, the one we just created. And right now we do PHP artisan serve. Now, well, with this we'll get some error, okay? Now, first thing, let's come inside this folder. I would open up this one, and we need to do some setup before we go ahead and run the command. So here I'll open it up using notebook, and a few of the things that we need to change right now. So over here, let's see database. Okay, so here is our database name. So I'll change it to shopping app. And for Xampp server, the default name is root and password is empty. So you can just skip that. But if you used any password for Xampp server during installation, then you have to put it over here. But in default setting, it's empty. So after that, I'll save it, Control S, and then I'll close this one, okay? Now, right after this, I'll go ahead and do PHP artisan serve, okay? Now, let's go ahead and see what's happening over here. Okay, so now here, it says that it served up over here, so I'll copy this one and come over here, and I'll paste it, okay? Now here it did say that it couldn't find server.php, okay? Now yes, this file is missing. Now what I'll do, I'll go ahead and do Control C and it would be closed. But when you do PHP artisan serve, if you might have some error related to composer that composer couldn't find auto load and things like that. In that case, you have to run first composer update, and composer update actually solves a lot of the problems. Okay, so we need to work on this one, but I don't have, but in some installation you might have this problem. Okay, but right now just it says that it couldn't find server.php. Now server.php is crucial for Laravel applications, but in our folder over here inside this it's missing. Okay, now what I'll do, I already have server.php in my other Laravel application which I showed you early, now like this one. So I will just go ahead and copy this one, server.php, yeah, this one. Okay, so I'll just copy. Okay, now if you can't find it, just go ahead and Google. In our case, I would do cn.bing.com. And here you can just, well, in your case, you can use Google because I'm in China. I can't access Google, Laravel server.php. Okay, so now you'll just go ahead and copy the file if you don't have it. Okay, this is the old file. Just go ahead and copy. And then all you need to do, you need to come inside this one. This shopping app, and over here we'll create a new file. You can call it server.php, but I already copied it, so I'll paste it over here. Okay, if you don't have, just copy from here and make a new file and call it server.php and paste it over here inside your root directory of this shopping app. Okay, now with this we are good. Now I'll go ahead and run php artisan server artisan serve and we'll see what happens. Okay, now it's started serving again. Now in this case I'll just go ahead and refresh it and we'll see what happens. Yes, now this is the front end of our Laravel application. We don't need it now, but in future we have to change it. We'll do that step by step, but now we'll go to the admin panel. Okay, I'll just simply do /admin and it'll take me over here like this. Okay, now because previously I already have the same application, so it's coming from the cache. Okay, so I just logged out. Now over here I would do admin and admin. Okay, so now let me type in admin one more time. Now here I would do login. Okay, all right, so it took me over here. All right, so and here we go, see our food category, users, food, the food that we have already. And now here is the thumbnail. Now thumbnail is not showing up. Now the reason is because over here if you hover over on it, you see that it's there, but after localhost there should be a slash, okay, uploads, like that. So that's why it couldn't find it. Now we can work around this thing. I mean, well, that's definitely a problem. Now that's coming from here inside admin folder, inside controllers, inside the food controller. Okay, now all you need to do, you need to open it with we don't need to go over there for this one. I'm sorry about that. Actually, we can simply change it over here. Okay, so let's see, open it with notebook and okay, so actually we can change our env file and over here we'll put a slash right after it. Okay, and it should do the trick. Okay, now we'll save it and after that we'll come over here once again and refresh it. And we'll see that the images are showing up slowly. Let's see, they did not. Okay, now I'll go ahead and copy this one, the link, and I'll put over here and we'll see what's going on. Now the localhost uploads images was not found. Let's see what's going on. So we'll come over here and we'll go to public uploads images. All right, yes, we do have the images that we supposed to have. Okay, let's try with the port number. So our port is 8, this one, and instead of this, let's go ahead and try 127.0.0.1. Let's save it. Okay, now let's go ahead and reload them. Okay, now it showed up. Okay, now on different server they act a bit differently, but anyway, it should be good for Linux as well. Okay, now with this you go ahead and do your backend thing and on you install it on Windows. Okay, well, if you still have questions, you can leave a comment below. Thank you.